When it comes to the Holy Quran, there is no question the Quran talks about the form, the concept of hijab, but not with the word of hijab. The word hijab, when it's used in the Quran, that word is used to mean a barrier. Barrier. It's not used to mean that, you know, the scarf and, for example, the proper, let's say, Islamic attire, the modest dress, if you may call it that way. Allah says, if you want to ask the wives of the Prophet a question, فَاسْأَلُوهُنَّ مِنْ وَرَاءِ حِجَابٍ. Hijab means a barrier. So that's the word hijab. That's how it's used in the Holy Quran. But later on, the word was used to reflect, to talk about this modest dress. In the Quran, in Surah An-Nur, ayah number 31, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ أَنْ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنْ وَيَحْفَضْنَ فُرُوجَهُنْ. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلْيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَى جُيُوبِهِنْ. And let them use the khimar to cover their bosoms. What does that mean? Linguistically, it's a beautiful explanation. If you put a piece of a scarf on your head, then you have two of these dangling, you know, sides. Some of the women at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, what they used to do is they used to just keep it dangling like this. And if she's wearing a necklace, she wanted to show that she's wearing a necklace. So she will wear a shirt, but the necklace would be visible on her chest, for example. Quran came to say no. وَلْيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَى جِيُوبِهِنَّ. Let them wear the scarf, but let them cover. They have to cover their chest and their neck area. In Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah says about جلابيبهن فليدنين عليهن من جلابيبهن ذلك أدنى أن يعرفن فلا يؤذين. They have to wear jilbab. Jilbab is some loose clothing. Loose. In other words, things which does not show the figure, reveal the figure of the body. That's a jilbab. Okay. So when you put the two ayahs together, then the whole body must be covered head to toe, with the exception of the face and the hands up to the wrist. And the clothing must be loose clothing on the body, that it should not show or reveal the figure of the individual. The head must be covered as well, with the exception of the face. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam also came to clarify it to us, to assert it to us, that this is the definition of the modest dress. In addition, وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنْ. They should not show their zina. Zina is referred to as any, what we call today, makeup. Makeup should not be revealed to al-ajnabi, someone who's not a mahram. When a lady goes outside to the public, she must not wear any makeup. At home, it is mustahab, highly recommended to wear the makeup to the husband. Today, انقلبت الآية. Things have changed today. A woman puts on her best makeup when she goes outside, but when she's at home, no makeup at all. She puts on her best perfume when she goes outside, but when she's at home, no perfume at all. This is opposite to what the Sharia says.